All right, so you're working on a project and you want to measure a battery, say like this 9-volt battery. Well, if you're using something like an Arduino, such as this one, you can't simply take and put the 9-volt directly into an analog in. You'll blow the input. So what can you do? Well, you can use two resistors as a voltage divider, which is what we're going to talk about in this AddOhms video. Let's start with a quick Ohm's law overview using this resistor. Adding a battery creates a very simple circuit. If we give the resistor 10 ohms of resistance, the omega symbol means ohms, and make the battery voltage 10 volts, Ohm's law tells us how much current will flow through the circuit. According to Mr. Georg Ohm, current is equal to voltage divided by resistance. In this case, that's the battery's 10 volts divided by the resistor's 10 ohms, which gives us 1 amp of current. So what happens when we add another 10 ohm resistor and call it R2? This creates a series circuit. Think about this circuit from the electron's point of view. We've just doubled the amount of resistance all of the electrons leaving the battery sees. Now our current calculation becomes 10 volts divided by 20 ohms for a total current of 500 milliamps. What about the voltage of R1 and R2? They can't both be 10 volts, and here's why. To find the voltage drop of each, we, again, will use Ohm's law. Let's look at R1 first. We know it is 10 ohms with this 500 milliamps of current flowing through it. Ohm's law says the voltage drop will be resistance times the current, which comes out to be 5 volts. Now, since R2 has that same 500 milliamps of current flowing through it, it's also going to have a voltage drop of 5 volts too. See, each electron has to go from the battery, through R1, and then through R2, back to the battery. One thing to notice is that the voltage drops of all the components in this circuit add up to the original source voltage. In a series circuit, components have the same current flowing through them, while their voltage drops add up. Okay, new scenario. What if we change the value of R2 to something else, like, say, 100 ohms? Since we are changing one element of our circuit, we have to start all over. Let's start with the total circuit current, which is now 10 volts divided by R1 plus R2, which is now 110 ohms. This gives us a current of about 91 milliamps. The voltage of R1 is 10 ohms times 91 milliamps, which gives us 0.91 volts, or 91 millivolts. Looking at the voltage of R2, it is now 100 ohms times 91 milliamps, which comes out to 9.1 volts. So can you see what happened? By making R2 10 times bigger than R1, the voltage drop of R2 is also 10 times bigger than R1. We effectively divided our voltage coming from the battery. There is a problem with using these resistor values. We've been focusing on the voltage, but let's take a look at the current. At 10 volts and 91 milliamps, we are wasting 0.91 watts. Almost 1 watt of power is being wasted by these resistors. It would make much more sense for us to use values like 10K or 100K for a divider, which reduces the amount of power wasted. How would you like a faster way to calculate the voltage divider? Check this out. Vout is equal to R2 divided by R1 plus R2 times Vin. There's no need to calculate the currents in this case. For example, let's say you have a 9-volt battery with a 47 kilo ohm resistor and a 6.8 kilo ohm resistor. It's okay, I'll wait while you calculate this out. Just kidding. Vout is going to be 6.8K divided by 47K plus 6.8K times 9 volts, which should give us an output of 1.13 volts. Okay, so we've taken a look at what the resistor values that go into a voltage divider. Using this magic formula, you should be able to calculate those values rather easily. If you have any questions about this video or suggestions for future topics, feel free to leave comments. In the meantime, make sure you follow and subscribe AddOhms so that you know when new tutorials are released.